Virgo singles, hello and welcome to your weekly reading with Angelic Ascension's Tarot. My name is Angela. And just a quick side note, I have available on my website the 2018 12-month forecast. So what I do with that is I give you a forecast of the entire 12 months of 2018 so you can get a preview of what each month is going to offer you. And that is currently available at my website. I advise for you to check your sun, moon, and rising just in case this doesn't resonate or to get a clearer picture of your situation. And keep in mind that anything that I say in this reading can go vice versa, because for a lot of these readings, it looks like there's a third party situation. So there are multiple people involved. So if it's not you playing something out in this scenario, it is someone else. So just apply the reading in, according to how it plays out in your situation, however it fits and resonates for your personal situation. Let's get started. The Ace of Wands is your overall energy. So I'm feeling like some of you may be taking the initiative to start something. You want a new start and you are ready for this. This is something that you are very diligent about. This is something that you're very serious about. So I'm saying that you are wanting to move forward. You're starting out a new journey. You're making a new start because you've got the Fool card. Oh, and with these cards, I do read reversals, but these cards are double-sided. So one side is reversed, the other side is the upright. So you have the upright side of the Fool, as if you are starting a new adventure, you are moving forward, you are starting out on a new journey. There's something that you want in a situation. And I'm seeing the Two of Cups in reverse, as if this was a situation where you felt like you lost your soulmate. And there was some type of a decision that you were being faced with here with the Two of Swords. Water in the tarot represents emotion. And if you take a look at this water, it's very turbulent. So there was a very emotional decision that needed to be made. And it looks as though, you see how her arms are folded across her chest, as if someone was refusing to make a decision. Someone's blindfolded as if they don't want to see something. So I'm feeling like this was someone keeping a situation in stagnation, not wanting to make a decision, not wanting to move forward. And I feel like all of this is fear of making the wrong decision or just being complacent. You know, keep in mind, her eyes are blindfolded, her arms are crossed. I feel like that's complacency. And I definitely get that here as a clarifier. Someone was feeling very complacent in a situation. I feel like there was someone that was afraid to move away from something that was very familiar, even though it wasn't for their highest good, because keep in mind, the water is very rocky and very, there's like a strong feeling of unrest. This could have been a rocky relationship that you were in, but I'm feeling like someone's mind is very conflicted as well, and there's a lot of confusion in whatever decision someone was trying to make. I feel like, okay, so we've got the King of Pentacles. So this could have been your energy, Virgo, or you could have been dealing with a fellow Virgo, Taurus, or Capricorn. Someone is very business focused, very focused on their career and money in the situation. This could be someone in the scenario that is being a bit of a workaholic or was a bit of a workaholic in the past to try to escape from the reality of the situation that they were going through. I'm feeling as though, okay, so we've got the Devil in reverse. So for some of you, this is a Capricorn, or this could be a placement in your chart. I'm feeling like someone has released themselves from a toxic situation. This could be someone that has addictions to alcohol or drugs, or someone who is a bit of a womanizer, or vice versa. It could be a woman that is very promiscuous, and someone that is addicted to maybe self-sabotage, something, anything that is of a lower vibration and is not for your highest good. So I feel like someone is trying to release themselves, probably from a turbulent relationship where there's a lot of chaos, conflict, and fighting. So, yeah, I'm feeling like someone just stayed complacent in the midst of a lot of chaos that was going on around them. Someone was just, you know, deciding not to move out of a situation that was very toxic and turbulent. But it looks like someone has gathered their bearings and they're about to move forward. For some of you, this is a Cancer. It looks like someone could be moving, actually changing locations and moving themselves out of a toxic situation. It looks as though someone was feeling left out in the cold. Someone's feeling depressed. Someone's feeling like a situation is hopeless. Feeling like they're just powerless to change something. So this is how someone could have been feeling in this scenario in the past. I'm also, yeah, here with Vanity and Three of Cups, I'm feeling like someone just is all about ego and shallowness and the attention of other people. You know, maybe self-gratification, overindulgence, a lack of self-control. But there was definitely deception in this situation. Someone was wearing a false mask. And I feel like over time, you recognize this. This could have been someone at a point in your life that brought you a lot of joy and a lot of happiness. But because this is a third party situation, I'm seeing that someone could have left and walked away. Or someone is leaving a situation, possibly, and moving forward into something that makes them more happy, that makes them feel stable and away from all of this turbulence and chaos. Looks like someone's leaving a situation because they're definitely feeling the loss of a soulmate connection. It's like someone has opened their eyes and they've seen what it is that they've lost. There's mental clarity that has been gained in the situation. Yeah, indeed. This is someone that could have left you for someone else, believing that they could, that someone else was better, or that they have a better circumstance or situation with someone else, but all they got was chaos and conflict. And they were very complacent and sat there and decided not to make a decision, even though they knew that getting out of that situation was for their highest good. You could have had this on-again, off-again relationship with this person, or this could have been someone who cheated on you repeatedly, who had multiple other people that they were dealing with outside of the relationship. So, someone is leaving a situation because they are facing the facts. Keep in mind, this is a three-party situation. They're facing the facts that there just isn't enough, there wasn't enough attraction or chemistry to keep this other relationship going. They were unhappy. So I feel like someone is definitely facing this period of unhappiness and confusion and frustration and conflict. And someone is walking out of a situation and into a situation that makes them very happy and feels like, makes them feel like they're themselves again. So someone is boldly leaving a situation where they're unhappy because they came to reality about who it is that they're dealing with and what type of situation that they were dealing with. Someone is no longer wanting to be complacent. So that's what this leap of faith is about. Someone is taking a leap of faith out of a situation that is no longer for their highest good. And this could have been how the situation played out between you and this partner in the past. Definitely someone has garnered some wisdom in the situation and they realize that this situation just was not for them and they are determined to move forward and find a situation that is even better for them. Find something that is for their highest good. So someone in the scenario is very depressed, could be drinking a bit too much because of the depression. And I feel like someone is wanting to just bring the joy back in their life. So I feel like you could have had a family with this person. We have the Ten of Cups. So this could be what someone is in search of. They are leaving this relationship because I'm seeing that someone wants a second chance here. Someone's wanting a second chance with the Judgment card. And yeah, someone is moving forward into something that makes them happy again. So this could be this person returning into this situation with you because they realize that they've left a good thing. So they were facing a fork in the road, but it looks like someone has made a decision and they've really been thinking this over. You really have been on this person's mind, Virgo. And here it is with the Fool and Come to the Edge. Someone is about to take a leap of faith and ask for a second chance because this is someone that's now willing to put in the effort. They realize that they made a mistake and they realize that you are their soulmate. So whatever it was that was having them in this place of complacency, unwillingness to change and move, even though they were in a situation that made them very unhappy, it looks like they've garnered the wisdom to let this go. Okay, so they're coming back for this second chance. We got the Ace of Cups. So this is someone that wants to start new with you. This is someone that wants this Ten of Cups and feels like they missed out on this opportunity in the past. And this is someone that is serious this time. They want to establish roots with you. They feel at home with you. They feel like they can be themselves with you. Because in the situation that they were in before, it just wasn't for their highest good. And they've been able to realize that. So this could be someone who is coming back for a commitment. Maybe someone is looking at marriage because we have the Four of Wands here, which talks about stability. It talks about ceremonies. And for some of you, this could have been a Taurus specifically. And we've got the Devil, or possibly a Centaur. For some of you, it could have been a Sagittarius, or it could have been a Capricorn. But yeah, okay. Maybe. But it looks like someone wants to move forward and have a true commitment, possibly even marriage. Someone is wanting to bring this situation into something serious that could even lead to marriage. It looks like someone is wanting a relationship for the long haul. For some of you, you've been very patient here. For some of you, it was a Sagittarius. Temperance. Some of you have exercised great patience with this person. You know, maybe this is something that you've been waiting for quite some time. With the Six of Coins, I definitely see that this is someone that was very much in their ego and someone that had a lot of pride. So I know that it is for someone to come out of their comfort zone and drop their pride, this is pretty big. For some of you, it could have been a Leo. But this takes a lot of boldness and courage for this person to come forward and leave a situation behind. This is the Knight of Wands in reverse. Okay, so yeah, indeed, this is someone that was much a player in the past. This is someone that definitely liked the attention of others. This is someone that was a flirt. Someone that was faithful to you as long as they were by your side in public, but behind your back, this is someone that was not faithful at all. They were flirting. They liked the attention of multiple people. They liked all eyes on them. So you will get communication from someone, this person from the past. For some of you, it could have been an Aquarius. This could have been something that you've been waiting and hoping for. This is someone that you felt stabbed you in the back. You felt betrayed by this person. Now someone's waking up and gaining mental clarity and realizing the truth for themselves. And they're realizing that you are the one. So you felt a lack of closure with this person in the past. But now it looks as though this person could have been holding on to you for quite some time. And someone is definitely about to leave a situation. This could be someone at a distance from you that is traveling forward, but this is definitely an ex of yours, someone from the past. Could be a Virgo. This could be your energy, Virgo. You know, you could be going through your hermit mode right now. You could be disconnecting from the world. Or this could have been your situation in the past, you know, just MIA from the situation. You know, even if it was going to work to just clear your mind, to not deal with the chaos and conflict. But, okay, Pisces for some of you. Okay, so someone was keeping secrets in the past. Yeah, indeed, this could be someone that you've had a family with. This is someone that wants longevity. This is someone that wants this relationship for the long haul. This was something that was emotionally draining. And someone is definitely about to release themselves here with the Eight of Swords. They're about to release themselves from a situation that had them tied and stuck. This is someone that brought illusions to the table and was a bit of a charmer. Could be a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio for some of you. Someone gave up on a situation and let it go. Something that wasn't for their highest good. And someone's wanting to bring healing to a situation where there was heartbreak and pain. So it's as if the Most High has put you in a situation that is getting you ready. Okay, because someone is about to take the initiative. Someone is poised and ready to take the initiative to take a leap of faith back into someone from the past. Back into a situation with someone from the past. I'm seeing that finances could be an issue for some of you. Someone in the scenario, but I'm seeing that provisions will be made. Milk and Honey talks about unexpected gains, unexpected provisions being made for you. So it looks like this time around, Virgo, it's going to be about cooperation instead of competition. Okay, because we've got the right smack dab in the middle of your reading is the Magician. The Magician talks about you have the ability and you have everything in front of you to manifest whatever it is that you want, whatever it is that you desire. So this new unction in you that's wanting you to move forward, you can make it happen. I feel like there was a lot of self-doubt and insecurity in the past, but I'm seeing that someone is developing the boldness and the trust and faith to move forward. Is definitely someone is exercising their faith in the situation. Queen of Cups, she is someone that is very much a nurturer. I'm seeing that this, she gives off a strong motherly vibe. So for someone, this could be the mother of your children, possibly, or there's some type of a strong, prominent, womanly situation. But I'm feeling like this is a family situation. So someone may be leaving one situation to return to a family that they left behind in the past. Because someone has decided to free themselves and become single from a situation that no longer served them in the past. All right, Virgo singles. Let's take a look at how the soulmate feels about you and how you are feeling about the soulmate. Okay, Holy Spirit, show me how the soulmate is feeling about Virgo at this present time. How is the soulmate feeling about Virgo in the present moment? Shuffle. Okay, Holy Spirit, how is the soulmate feeling? Okay. The soulmate wants to hear from you, Virgo. This is someone that you could have, it looks like you left this person for someone else in the past because you felt like you'd have a better situation. Or this could have been soulmate. They felt like they had a better connection with someone else. And it looks like one of you left a situation where you came to the reality that this was not the right fit for you. This was something that did not serve your highest good. So someone needs to hear from you. This could be how the soulmate is feeling. That they need to hear from you. And they need these heart-to-heart, honest conversations with you to see if this is really the right fit. And are the two of you on the right page? Because I'm definitely seeing that someone is feeling impatience about a situation. So maybe this is you, Virgo. You're feeling impatience to leave a situation that is full of chaos and frustration and causes a lot of self-doubt for you. So I'm seeing that the soulmate recognizes that this is a true connection that the two of you have. They recognize you as the soulmate. And this could be someone that has been waiting for contact from you for quite some time. So yeah, looks like the soulmate wants to hear from you. And this is someone that wants the passion and the happiness reignited in the relationship. Because the soulmate realizes that this is you, you're the one. Let's take a look at how Virgo is feeling about the soulmate at this present moment. Okay, there could be religious factors or difference in your spiritual path or upbringing. Okay, there's definitely a lot of attraction here, and this card came out immediately. I feel like there is mutual attraction between you and this person, this soulmate of yours. Okay, so someone is definitely retreating from a situation. Someone is letting something go. Something that caused a lot of conflict and pain and confusion. Okay, what else, Holy Spirit? Yeah, indeed, there is a separation. Someone is walking away from a soon-to-be ex to return to their soulmate. And, yep, reconciliation. Let go of control issues and allow this situation to unfold naturally. And at the bottom of the deck, express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. So Virgo, someone is waiting to hear from you. Someone is waiting for you to express your love. It looks like you want this. You are happy about this. You're willing to put in the time, energy, and effort to reconcile with this person. But they need to hear from you. They need to know that your feelings are sincere. They need to hear that. They need to hear the truth from the heart. A heartfelt conversation, not just something that's on the surface. Because I feel like there's someone that's vain here. This is someone that maybe doesn't want to admit defeat. You know, they don't want to admit that they made a mistake by choosing someone else. This is someone that has pride issues. So it looks as though someone may be reluctant to come forward and realize, you know, admit that they made a mistake. But yeah, it looks like Virgo, the soulmate, needs to hear from you. So it's going to be necessary for you to let go of control issues. Stop worrying about how you're going to sound or, you know, feeling like you just don't want to admit that you made a mistake. Just go ahead and move forward. Step out on faith. Take that initiative, which was your overall energy. Take that initiative and move forward and tell this person how you feel. Because I can tell that you feel like you lost your soulmate. And you're feeling sad about it. You're not happy about this. And it looks like you're ready to come out of conflict, whether this is mental conflict or literal conflict or both. Okay. So some of you realize that there's something better. And so that's why you set out on this new journey. Holy Spirit, what advice do you have for Virgo singles moving forward with someone from the past? Okay, so something is about to take place in the near future. And at the bottom of the deck, let's see, let me shuffle one more time. Okay. Listen to your intuition, Virgo. You're ready, and it's up to you. It's up to you, whatever you decide. And at the bottom of the deck, you have yes. Okay, so Virgo singles, this concludes your weekly reading with Angelic Ascensions Tarot. If you're interested at all in booking a reading with me, all of my information is below in the description box. And I'm still available for Instant Go. So for any of you who are interested in texting me, because I only have the text option open. Don't call, because that will only delay things. Go ahead and text me your question and I will get back to you within 24 to 48 hours. It doesn't always require the full 24 to 48 hours, but I will get back to you. Okay, and if you did find that this reading did resonate, go ahead and do me a favor and hit the like button, and feel free to leave a comment below. Thank you everyone for your support to my channel. Thanks for watching the videos. And if you're interested in subscribing, hit the subscribe button and don't forget to hit the bell so that you get all of the notifications. All right, everyone, stay safe out there. I'll see you again next week. Bye for now.